support divesting from Wells Fargo very strongly. I actually did not realize one of the people ahead of me was going to speak in favor of a public bank. I hadn't heard the idea out. One of the council members let me know when I wrote in that there is a measure for a state bank in the legislature. If it doesn't, that would be the ideal. If it doesn't make it out, I'm wondering what the options are for a city or county bank or whatever. I would like to urge the council to think outside the box in looking for options. The thing about a state or city or county bank is it would give us the greatest control over social justice issues. We don't have to check out every day and see whether we can control the social justice situation. And so this is why I would like to see us go that route. And I suggested city or county, all I'm saying is think outside the box. And I don't know what the feasibility of this stuff is. I'm suggesting it, but I don't know what's feasible and reasonable. But I'd like us to consider the options.
Thank you.
Followed by Sarah Lindell or Lindell.
Hi, Paul Revere. Thank you for the chance to speak. I commend you for the effort on this, and I hope that the idea, I hope it will pass, but I also hope it will spread to other cities. The problem we're dealing with is goes all the way back to the Constitution when the founders wrote the central bankers out of the Constitution, and they kept on trying to get a charter and get a charter. And what happened was Thomas Jefferson said, if you let the central bankers issue your currency, the corporations through inflation, deflation, and hyperinflation will rise up around you and conquer you. And it's exactly what's happening, only because in 1913, the Majestic 12 of the monarchist families of Europe created the Federal Reserve Act, which is the Fed, and under it are the banks, the insurance companies and other corporations that are controlling us today. And so JFK impeached the Fed, and these guys made sure that President Obama didn't know that if he impeached the Fed, we can have our own banking system as the founders had intended. And today, they're actually controlling our money and our country. So we're kind of beyond that at this point because Trump's in power. Perhaps a local bank. I know that they wouldn't allow it down. The GOP will not allow a state bank. But you might try a King County bank.
Thank you. Sarah.
Yeah.
I'll move back to you. Katie, Megan, Jean, Megan, and they might be downstairs coming up. I'm not sure. Sarah, LaPelle, Kate, Megan, 3738. And then I have Merle Adler. Earl Adler here, and I have Raymond Kingfisher here. Do I have any of those parties here? Raymond, please. Hello, sir.
Good afternoon. I'm on the councilman. My name is Raymond Kingfisher. Originally from Niger, Montana, I live in Federal Way. I want to thank you all for bringing this issue this far, to be able to bring this issue up and to be able to vote on it and hopefully pass it. I speak for people who can't be represented. I speak for the homeless people who are addicted to alcohol and drugs. I speak on behalf of animals, the fish, the water, birds in the sky that are going to be affected by this pipeline going underneath Lake Oahu, which is also known as the Missouri River. So today, our people that are standing up, our warriors, are awaiting this decision. They're patiently waiting in that 15-degree weather, and they're anticipating for you to pass this so that this movement will continue on a national level. So ask you humbly to pass this ordinance on behalf of all water protectors of our nations, because water is life. Aho.
Councilwoman 1186, a bereavement is at our claims and order to give it their own.
Okay, I'll move to pass Council Bill 118906. Move to second, the bill passes. Any further comments? Please call the roll on the passage of the bill.
Herbert.
Aye.
Johnson.
Aye.
Juarez.